just thinking about communicating, which is ultimately what we're trying to do on here, in a range of different ways, whether it be, you know, from the completely superficial to the deeply profound. We're trying to touch people out there with our words or our creativity or our concepts or our theories or our ideas or our desires for change or our anger or whatever. And it was one of Fred's videos, which I may attach this to, which set me off, because I can't say with any certainty, I know he engages with different people in different ways, but I think he gets the various different ways that I communicate. The video that I'm talking about is a very specific discussion, exploration of one single word in order to achieve understanding. And I often feel that one needs to do this in order to actually communicate with pretty much every word. Whilst there are some people we have a natural rapport with, somehow, for whatever reason, an alignment with a profound comprehension of where the other person is coming from, or an apparent comprehension. And I think that's an important distinction. I've been noticing in the past few days that people said quite a few times on various different videos from different people, I understand exactly what you mean, and then go on to suggest, at least to me, that they don't. They understand from their own perspective, which is absolutely fine, but they don't understand what the video maker is actually meaning. Now, does that matter? Not sure. But quite often, well, in the work I've done over the years, I have tried to communicate in the language and the framework and the context of the individual that I am working with. That is my job, as I have seen it, to find a way to say the things that I need to say in a way which will make sense to them. Otherwise, it's a completely pointless exercise, and it's not their job to speak my language. You know, teaching them some kind of therapy speak is just absurd. I need to kind of meet people where they are, and sometimes that's easier than others, and sometimes it's impossible. Not very often has it proved to be impossible, because it's, in a way, being a therapist is in some respects like being an interpreter. But I've thought then many times, you know, only one word needs to be misunderstood in a sentence, let alone a whole explanation, and you're on completely different roads. You're not talking about the same thing at all, even though it might appear so. And I think that's sometimes when, you know, it looks like there's a parallel and real interaction, but actually what's happening is that, you know, the paths are going further and further apart, and eventually the parties realise, and there may be a conflict or a parting of the ways or whatever, you know, the wished for ideas or engagement. But also what I tend to do is to communicate, particularly in videos or art, and I mean, you know, some of my videos are artistic or creative, at least, expression, is to communicate either without words or with a basic framework of words surrounded by imagery, or communicate on many different levels for the viewer to interpret in whatever way works for them. I mean, one of the things that has always irritated me about art or poetry or whatever, is that people try and interpret things exactly the way that the artist or writer has intended. Sometimes it's obvious, of course, but other times the whole point is that you understand it in your own way and that it has an impact on you from the perspective that you find yourself. And when that happens, the creator is effectively giving it away. They're expressing something of themselves, but not expecting or desiring even an external engagement of the understanding of that piece, simply to have that impact or that inspiration or offering that food for thought or feeling or something along those lines. And that might seem to be an obtuse form of communication, but I think in many ways it can be an extremely acute one. It can cut through the external crap or the conscious or the avoidance, the conditioning, and get to the heart of things. Because it kind of goes in through a back door, it slips underneath the radar of the conscious mind and of the desire for things to be a specific way. I think when you do things with your head, when you're cerebral about things, when you play with words, whilst in some respects you can achieve a huge clarity, in other ways it can be a real avoidance that you, whilst you're seeking understanding that you can, though that's not always the case, be also seeking to maintain things exactly as they are. Whereas with a more creative way of doing things, you're letting go more. And sometimes someone will do something in a video and I'll think, they may be responding to something I've done. They may not. But either way, it makes me smile or it makes me think, because it is somehow in tandem or a spark from, a step on from what I have expressed myself. And whether I have sparked that or not doesn't actually matter. There is some kind of extended connectivity that pleases me.